Well, Prince Andrew is making headlines this morning, revealing he's considering giving a tell-all book interview to work his way back into royal life.
Oh, I mean,
talking about submarines.
He'll try anything, won't he? Let's bring in Royal Editor of the Daily Mirror, Russell Myers. Russell, has Prince Harry started something here? Can his uncle follow suit?
Yeah, well, good morning, both of you. Well, I think he has, and certainly Andrew has been wanting to get a slice of the action. I mean, I'm not too sure how well Harry has done on these sort of promotional tours. I mean, it's been written about and ridiculed, but I suppose that Prince Andrew has already had that. So he feels he's got nothing to lose. I mean, he was absolutely disintegrated after his BBC Newsnight interview, but over the last couple of years, he's even had a further fall from grace. So this will be a big problem for the King. It will be a big problem for the royal family if he goes along with it. But my understanding is he's had at least two big offers from US broadcasters at the moment, so he's mulling them over.
Well, why wouldn't you when you're getting that sort of cash that Harry was? I think, to be fair, Harry's a little more appealing and his story is a little bit more engrossing. What about this story? Prince Charles has denied paying for Andrew's Indian healing that came at a pretty hefty price tag.
I mean, this is, again, extraordinary. Andrew was apparently billing the privy purse, which is obviously coming from the Queen's finances that were coming from taxpayer funds as well, up to $60,000 a year. And this was from some sort of yogi who was having sleepovers at his house. They were doing holistic therapy.
What on earth?
Chanting yoga. I mean, it's nothing is off limits with Andrew, it seems, and it goes from bizarre to ridiculous.
Well, yes. I mean, look, where does the money come from? Is a legit question, that situation. I mean, if I could have a guru stay with my house, you know, for a year, it'd be awesome.
Hymns and all kinds of.
Anyway, the mind still boggles, Rusty. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Well, best actor nominee Brendan Fraser.